We have a fantastic new product to show you called Rag Detective. Let's get going. ChatGPT was released in November 2022 to widespread acclaim and amazement. Finally, we have an artificial intelligence that has both the wisdom and reasoning to answer any question. There was even speculation that it could eventually replace search engines like Google. This view has somewhat faded from public discourse as it's become more and more well known that GPT models sometimes just don't know things. ChatGPT's responses are based on the information it was trained on, effectively freezing its knowledge at a certain point in time. Another problem is hallucinations. Hallucinations happen when a model confidently invents false information. This happens because the model is generating responses based on patterns it learned from its training data, rather than using verified data. In this exaggerated example, it makes up its own definitions for the acronym SCUBA. It likely would never make this error with a well-known word like SCUBA, but actual hallucinations often go unnoticed, until they cause real damage. A lawyer 2 years out of law school used ChatGPT to write a legal document due to heavy workload. He later discovered it included several fake citations. This resulted in his firing from his law firm. One way to solve these problems is with Retrieval Augmented Generation, which uses a factual current reference to give LLMs the information they need to answer questions. To introduce our product, meet Paul. He's a product manager for an AI startup in a space with lots of new products and competitors. Paul is also aware of the limitations of large language models. Paul wants to be able to ask questions about competitor offerings with natural language and have them answered in the same manner. He wants the answers to his questions to reflect what's currently on the competitor's website, and he wants to know if the answers he gets are financially good, bad, or neutral. Here's Paul's dream as a reality. We call it Rag Detective. We've both implemented RAG using a vector database called Weaviate and fine-tuned a Bert model to do financial sentiment analysis. Let's see how it works. First, you choose a website you want to query, then choose which scraping session you want by the timestamp. Each session represents the website's data at a given point in time. Enter a question about the website data, send the question and website data to GPT-3.5, watch as the answer is streamed back, along with the links to the pages that were used to answer the question. If the question was financial in nature, our helpful BERT model will tell you if the sentiment was positive, negative, or neutral. Want to scrape another company website? No problem. The page also has a built-in web scraper to add any website with a sitemap. Enter the website you wish to scrape or a direct link to an XML sitemap. The application will tell you how many pages it has found to scrape and logs everything. It then asks for confirmation to scrape the site. Click yes and watch in real time as it scrapes the site. We did run into some challenges. The modern internet has a variety of HTML and CSS structures, uses dynamic content, and sometimes even implements anti-scraping measures. We address much of this by using beautiful soup to parse HTML and Selenium to load dynamic content in a headless Chrome browser. As part of our orchestration process for RAG, we use some Python libraries that have only existed for a year or two. We ran into many issues where we could not find good documentation, and we've de-examined the source code ourselves. We're not sure if some of the methods we use are even officially part of their APIs. As part of the prompt we secretly give GPT-3.5, we ask it if the response it is giving is financial in nature. Its performance on this has been spotty, often to the point it appears random. The dataset we use for financial text classification to fine-tune BERT also had some hidden biases baked in. We went through an extensive experimentation period to determine the best data to get the most performant model. For scaling, to handle variations in traffic to Rag Detective, we use Google Kubernetes Engine to create a scalable infrastructure that automatically adapts to changing demands. Vertical autoscaling increases the compute capacity of a pod, and horizontal autoscaling adds more pods to a system to distribute the workload. Load balancing distributes incoming network traffic across multiple servers to ensure efficient resource utilization, prevent overload, and enhance system reliability and performance. Let's see a live demo of the app, hosted at ragdetective.com. Here we are at ragdetective.com. We're going to choose something that's already in the list here, ai21.com, and let's ask if it's had any financial funding. And yes, it has, and our BERT model says that that's neutral. Now let's ask if AI will change retail. It thinks that one is positive. Finally, let's ask who Kim Kardashian is. We don't care. Now let's refresh. Let's do a little bit of research. We see that Mistral has just released a brand new model, so let's try and scrape their site. It has 20 pages available to scrape. Let's do it. And now it's done. Let's see if we can ask what the model is. There's Mistral. What is Mistral? And there we have it. We even have a link to the page, and this model came out 8 hours ago, so it's not in GPT's training data.